You must change the IV catheter bandage once a week or any time it becomes loose, dirty, or wet. To change the bandage, first, wash your hands. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe to create a safe zone. If you'd like, cover your work surface with a clean paper drape. On your safe zone, place a bandage change kit, a clear bandage, a pair of non-sterile gloves, and, if they are used on this patient, an anchoring device and biopatch. Next, lift the corner of the paper cover on the tray of the bandage change kit. Carefully peel the cover to remove it from the tray. Put the cover into the trash. The inside of the tray is a sterile area. Do not touch the supplies in the tray with your fingers or anything that is not sterile. Carefully pick up the two masks from the top of the tray. Make sure not to touch any other item in the tray. If another person is helping you with the bandage change, have them put on the other mask. Place the white side of the mask over your mouth and nose with the metal piece on top. Pull the elastic loops around your ears. Pinch the metal piece over your nose. Gently pull the bottom of the mask under your chin to fit the mask to your face. Next, pick up the sterile glove packet from the top of the tray and place it onto the safe zone. Make sure not to touch any other item in the tray. Pick up the edge of the white folded drape and lift it out of the tray without touching other items in the tray. Hold the drape by its edges to unfold and shake the drape open. Place the shiny side of the drape onto the safe zone. Do not touch the open surface of the drape with your fingers or anything that is not sterile. The top of this drape is a sterile area. Peel open the clear bandage package and let the bandage fall from the package onto the drape. Do not touch the clear bandage with your fingers or anything that is not sterile. Repeat this process with the anchoring device and the biopatch if you are using them. Clean your hands with alcohol-based hand sanitizer. Then put on the non-sterile gloves. Loosen the edges of the old bandage. Gently pull the edges of the bandage toward the catheter entrance site from all directions. Put your thumb or forefinger over the catheter entrance site to hold the catheter in place while you peel off the old bandage. Do not pull on the catheter while removing the bandage. Put the old bandage into the trash. Remove the anchoring device and biopatch from the IV catheter if they are in place. Remove your non-sterile gloves and put them into the trash. Clean your hands with soap and water or with an alcohol-based hand gel. Open the sterile glove packet on the safe zone, handling only the edges of the packet. Do not touch the inside of the packet or the gloves with your fingers. Carefully pick up one of the sterile gloves by the rolled cuff and slide your other hand into the glove. Make sure not to touch the outside of the glove with your fingers on either hand while putting your hand into the glove. Pick up the other glove by sliding the fingers of your sterile gloved hand under the rolled cuff. Slide your other hand inside of the glove. Make sure not to touch the outside of the glove with your ungloved fingers while putting your hand into the glove. Do not touch anything that is not sterile once you have put on sterile gloves. Remove the chlorhexidine swab stick from the bandage change tray and open the package. Use the swab stick to clean the catheter exit site, the catheter, and the patient's skin that will lie under the bandage. Scrub the skin in an up and down, back and forth motion with one swab stick for at least 10 seconds. Repeat the 10-second scrub with each of the other two swab sticks in the package for a total cleaning time of 30 seconds. Allow the skin to dry completely. It may take several minutes to dry. Do not fan or blow on the skin to speed up the drying process. You can tell when the skin is completely dry, when it no longer looks shiny, and when your glove finger remains dry after you touch the site. Apply a biopatch and an anchoring device if you're using them for this catheter. Follow the manufacturer's or the IV nurse's instructions. Peel the paper backing off the sticky side of the clear bandage. Hold the bandage by the paper tabs around the rim of the bandage. Place the center of the sticky side of the bandage over the catheter entrance site. Press the entire bandage securely against the skin, covering the catheter entrance site and the anchoring device if you've used one. Remove the paper tabs from the edges of the clear bandage, and then press firmly all the way around the edge of the bandage to form a seal. Remove your mask and gloves and put them into the trash. Clean your hands. Take a strip of tape and tear a slit into the center of the strip. If there are tape pieces on the paper tabs of the clear bandage, you can use that instead. Apply one tape strip under the catheter tubing and over the top of the bandage edge to form a seal at the base of the bandage. Take another strip of tape and tear a slit in the center of the tape, or use a tape piece from the paper tabs of the clear bandage. Place the tape over the top of the catheter tubing to complete the seal.